In health news to use tonight, obesity and the likelihood of needing ICU care for COVID, and how teens with type 1 diabetes cope during the lockdown. We begin, though, with a new study that finds schools with more lower income or minority students were more likely to close during the COVID pandemic. Researchers from Columbia University used mobile phone data to track in-person visits to over 100,000 schools in 2020. They found closures were more common in schools with lower math scores, a higher share of racial minorities, or a large proportion of students eligible for free and reduced lunch. In October, 35% of white students were exposed to distance learning, compared to 52% of black students and 60% of Hispanic and Asian students. New research from Yale University shows obese COVID patients are significantly more likely to require ICU care. The study included data from over 3,000 adults who were hospitalized for coronavirus. It showed patients with obesity were 26% more likely to end up in the ICU than those with a normal range BMI. However, obese patients did not have a higher risk of dying from COVID. And finally, kids and teens with type 1 diabetes seem to have better glucose control during the COVID lockdown. Researchers in the UK tracked 180 youth with type 1 diabetes. In the 12 weeks before and after a national stay-at-home order was announced, they found a significant improvement in blood glucose measurements after the lockdown. Experts say these findings suggest families found it easier to manage the disease without the stress of school, social life, and peer pressure. Experts say the families of children dealing with type 1 diabetes really need extra support at school and during social events to prevent them from developing complications from diabetes later in life.